Hi dear students, welcome back to Mathematics Online class. Today, let us continue the next method, that is solution of the differential equation. One method is over, that is variable separable method is over. Now, the second method is homogeneous differential equation. When we need to say that differential equation is homogeneous, we are just solving the first order first degree differential equation. First order first degree differential equation is nothing but d by dx is equal to f of x comma y. This f of x comma y in the first method, variable separable method, this function can be expressed in terms of product of the two functions. One value in terms of x, one value in terms of y. That we have just taken particularly g of x into h of y. Product of the two functions we have expressed. A single function can be expressed in the form of product of two functions. G of x, h of y, then separating the variable, integrating, evaluating, which is for the corresponding solution of the differential equation. That is the variable separable method, first method. In this video, we are going to know that what is the homogeneous differential equation. First of all, let's come to know that what is meant by homogeneous function. First of all, what is the homogeneous function? So for that one, I just consider that, let us consider, I just consider a few example. F of x comma y is equal to 2x plus 3y. And the second function I just consider, f of x comma y is equal to x square plus 3y square. F3 of x comma y is equal to, that we can say that cos of y by x or x by y, cos of y by x. Then similarly, I just consider f of x comma y is equal to sine of x minus cos of x. Here, particularly, I just consider the core function. What are the core function? First function, that is in the form. Okay, f of x comma y is equal to 2x plus 3y. F of x comma y is nothing but x square plus 3y square. A function is that which is having a both variable x and y or two variable. F of x comma y is nothing but cos of y by x. F of x comma y is nothing but sin x minus cos x. Instead of considering that f of x is equal to some function x square plus 3x. Here only the one variable is there. That's why I just mentioned the f of x. Here two variables are there. Dependent variable, independent variable. So that I just consider in this manner. F of x comma y. Okay. Now, when we need to say that the given function is homogeneous. For that, what I just going to do means replace. To check that a given this function is homogeneous or not, replacing or replace x by lambda x and y by lambda y. Wherever x is there, replace the lambda x. Wherever y is there, replace the lambda y. And here lambda is non-zero constant. Lambda is a non-zero constant or any real number except the zero. Okay, so replacing this value. Wherever x is there, lambda x. Wherever y is there, lambda y. What happens? F1 of x comma y in place of x, what we have to replace? Lambda x. In place of y, what we have to replace? Lambda y. Replace it. 2 times of lambda x plus 3 times of lambda y. Can I take the lambda constant outside? Yes, lambda is outside. If the lambda is outside, what is your 2x plus 3y? Again, lambda. 2x plus 3y. 2x plus 3y is nothing but what? F1 of x comma y. Now check that. F1 of lambda x comma lambda y becomes lambda times f1 of x comma y. Are you got my point? In the same manner, second function, that is f2 of lambda x comma lambda y. What happens? Wherever lambda x is there, replace lambda x. Wherever y is there, replace the lambda y. Here, what happens? Lambda x whole square plus 3 into lambda y whole square. Simplified. That is lambda square x square plus 3 after this lambda square y square. Here also lambda square, here also lambda square. I just take the lambda square is outside. What is left? If you take the lambda square is outside, x square plus 3y square. X square plus 3y square is nothing but what? You have to of x comma y. Are you clear? Similar reason. F3 of lambda x comma lambda y is equal to wherever x is the replace the lambda x cos of lambda y divided by lambda x. Here lambda lambda will cancel. What is left? Cos of y by x only left. Cos of y by x I just write as lambda power 0. What is lambda power 0? Any number. Lambda is a non-zero real number. Lambda power 0 is 1. Any number power 0 is 1. So this is f2 of x comma, sorry, f3 of x comma y. F3 of x comma y is cos of y by x. Similarly, f4 is the f4 of lambda x comma lambda y is equal. What is it? We can write sin of lambda x minus cos of lambda x. In this case, is it possible to take the lambda is 1? Here, which is not possible to take the lambda is common, so that we can't express this in terms of lambda power sum of and f of x comma 1, which is not possible to write. So that reason, here I just make the conclusion. What is the conclusion? Means the f1, f2, f3, f1, f2, f3 are the homogeneous functions. Homogeneous function and f4 is not a homogeneous function. Then what is a homogeneous function? A function is of the form f of x comma y. A function is of the form f of x comma y can be expressed in the form of lambda power n into f of x comma y. Lambda power n into f of x comma y then is called nth degree homogeneous function. Is called a nth degree homogeneous function. Nth degree homogeneous function. This is the exactly the definition. What is the definition of the homogeneous function? F of x comma y is the function is that here is several functions are there. These functions can be expressed in the form of lambda power n into f of x comma y. Lambda power 1, lambda power 2, lambda power 0, where n is the any integer. First two integral index. That should be first integral index including the 0. So lambda power n into f of x comma y. This function can be expressed in this form. Then this function is said to be nth degree homogeneous function. Now it is a general definition. Now what is the degree of this homogeneous function? Lambda power how much? What is the integer is that? That is our degree of the homogeneous function. Here first degree homogeneous function, second degree homogeneous function, zeroth degree homogeneous function, and this is not a homogeneous function. So that I described that here f1, f2, f3 are the homogeneous functions. And f4 is not a homogeneous function. Why the f4 is not a homogeneous function? Because we can't express the f4 in the form of lambda power n into f of x comma y. So that reason is not a homogeneous function. I think you people have got that definition of the homogeneous function. What is the definition of the homogeneous function? The function f of x comma y can be expressed in the form of lambda power n into f of x comma y. Then it is called as a nth degree homogeneous function, where n is the any positive integral index. N is the positive integer including the 0. So this is all about the homogeneous function. Next, apart from this, one more thing is that
again we can express in the different manner. How to express in the different manner? Means
here this f1 of x comma y can be rewritten as like, how to rewrite is nothing but This can be that upon of x comma y can be again rewrite. Again rewrite is nothing but I just pick the x is common. If I take an x is common, what happens in the function? If I take an x is common, 2 plus 3 into y by x. X into 2 plus 3 into y by x. Suppose if you take an x is common. Then if you take a y is common, what happens? If you take a y is common, 2 into x by y plus 3 is happens. Are you sure? I got my point. Then similarly, f of x comma y can be expressed. Here f of x comma y, I just take the first of all x square is common. If you take an x square is common, what happens? This is 1 plus 3 into y square divided by x square. Again, if you take a y square is common, what happens here? Here, x square divided by y square plus 3. Now, are you following my point? What I am just doing? X I am just taken. Throughout, it is the, what is the degree of the homogeneous function? It is the first degree homogeneous function. Because lambda power 1 is there. This is the second degree homogeneous function because lambda power 2 is there. So that reason, I am just taking, once I just take the x is common, once I just take the y is common. Both we can take as a common. Here I just take the maximum power of the variable, x square I just taken or y square if we make it as common. Next, similarly, f3 of x comma y. In that f3 of x comma y, what we can take? Here, as I said, nothing is possible to take it as a common, keep as this because already it is in the standard form. What is the standard form? Let's come on. F4 is not a homogeneous function, no need to write. Here, I am just going to rewrite. How I am just going to rewrite this one? B is here. This we can rewrite. How to rewrite is nothing but I just write x into g of y by x. X into g of y by x. What is the g of y by x? G of y by x is nothing but this is the square bracket value is the g of y by x. Similarly, this you can write as y into h of x y by y into h of x y by. What I am just doing, are you following? The same function is the f1 of x comma y. What is the f1 of x comma y? 2x plus 3y is that 2x plus 3y. Here, once I just taken the x is common, if you take an x is common in this manner, if you take an y is common in this manner. Why I just taking the x and y are common means let's come to know the one more definition. So that reason I want to explain the another definition of the homogeneous function. So that reason. If you take an x is common, that it is said to be a variable power 1 is the first degree homogeneous function. Instead of telling that in this manner, this way also we can check the homogeneous function. Okay, this is first degree homogeneous function. This is also the same, either this one or this one. Okay, now similarly, here what we can write, x square is common is the x square. Here I just write the g of y by x. Here I just write g1, h1. Here I just write g2 of y by x. Or if you can write y square into h of y by x. Y square into h2 of y by x. Similarly, here I just write nothing is common. Nothing is common means we can write as x power 0 into g3 of y by x. Yes, x power 0 into g3 of y by x. Or y power 0 into s3 of x by y. It is already in the standard form. Not there is no question of writing the x by y. Only it is sufficient to write the y by x. Here observe the things what I just written. Here I am just going to take the definition. What is the definition? Means a function f of x comma y. A function f of x comma y is called a homogeneous function. Is called a homogeneous function. It is called a homogeneous function. When this function is said to be a homogeneous function, means whenever f of x comma y is equal to x power n into g of y by x. X power n into g of y. You may express this function x power n into g of y by x. This is called as a homogeneous function of the degree n. Or else, one more thing you can write. the function f of x comma y can be expressed in the form of y power n into h of x by y, then it is also called as a nth degree homogeneous function. This is also called as a nth degree homogeneous function. And the definition, the function f of x comma y can be expressed in the form of x power n into g of y by x is called a nth degree homogeneous function. Or f of y, x comma y can be expressed in the form of y power n into h of x by y, then it is called as a nth degree homogeneous function. Now here, whatever the variable power is there, this is the first integral it takes, including the zero. That is the degree of the function. What is the degree? Here 1 is the first degree. Here r first degree. Here second degree. Same thing we have computed in the previous method. Lambda power, whatever the value is there, that is the degree of the function. Here x power, variable power is what? That is our degree of the homogeneous function. Okay, this is all we have to call. Now we have checked that the given function is homogeneous or not. There are two methods are there to check the given function is homogeneous or not. First method is replacing the x as a lambda x and y as a lambda y, or else taking the maximum power of the variable is taking common. Take the common of maximum power of the variable. Okay, so here x is maximum power is 1 is that, I just taken x is common. Here maximum power of the variable is 2 is that, x square is taken common. In that manner we can express either first method or second method. Which one is suitable to you, that method we have to adopt. Okay, now homogeneous we have come to know that how to verify. Next thing is solution. How to solve the homogeneous differential equation? So that I just wrote this part. And one more thing, we are solving only the 0 to degree homogeneous function. There are 0 to degree is the first degree is the second degree, third degree, whatever the nth degree we can get it. But in the PVC second level, we are solving only the 0th degree homogeneous function. So method to solve homogeneous function. Homogeneous differential equation. How to solve the homogeneous differential equation? That is the method. So in that, first of all, consider the first order first degree differential equation dy by dx. Yes, consider dy by dx is equal to f of x comma y. Dy by dx is equal to f of x comma y. Here f of x comma y is the homogeneous function. F of x comma y is the homogeneous function. F of x comma y is the homogeneous function. Now, instead of writing f of x comma y, we can take it as a g of y by x. G of y by x. I am just solving the 0th degree homogeneous function. I am just solving this type of function, 0th degree homogeneous function. So that variable power, lambda power 0 is there, here x power 0 is there. And make the difference. Here if you take y by x, y by x if you take g of y by x, here x will be the power 0. If you take y is common, then we have to write the h of x by y. Okay, so I think if there is g of y by x is not covered in this video, I think we have already mentioned the point, so just observe it. Okay, here lambda power 0 is here. Now this is a differential equation, I need to solve this differential equation, so I just drop this part. How do you solve this one? This solution of this differential equation means we have to make the substitution. What is the substitution we have to make it at the first moment? Means whenever the differential equation is given, suppose for example previously we just solved several equations, so that is x plus y if they given. So here variable separable means our x into y is the same, x y is given. Variable separable, we know that separating the variable y comes on side, x comes on side, integrating we just get it. But in this case, first of all, we have to observe whether it is the first order, first degree is the differential. Once they have differential, first order, degree is 1. Okay, so first order first degree. Here also first order first degree is that. Here f of x now y is expressed as a product of two functions. One function in terms of x, one function in terms of y. Here homogeneous function. F of x now y can be expressed in the form of g of y by x or h of x by y. Okay, here I just consider first of all g of y by x. Suppose g of y by x is that means in this case how will you solve? Means I just call this is the equation number 1. Here I just going to do the solution. What is the solution? Means put y by x is equal to some other variable b. Put y by x is equal to b. Then I just write the y is equal to. What is the y is equal to? Y is equal to b into x. Y is equal to b into x. So I am just going to do the solution so that we need to replace the dy and the dx value. So that is in differentiate this way. Differentiating with respect to x. Differentiating with respect to x. Here y is a variable, x is a variable, b is also the variable. Differentiating with respect to x, what will get? Left hand side dy by dx is equal to here. We keep the here, differentiate the second function. Differentiation of x is 1, p into 1 plus x as it is. Differentiation of phi with respect to x is d by dx. So into 1, I just have it. Okay. So dy by dx is equal to product rule. What is the product rule? U into p o dash is equal to what is that? U into v dash plus u dash into p. Or else another first term, second term. Nothing to worry. If you interchange, doesn't matter. Anyway, I just got this one. Call this as equation number. Are you following my point? First of all, the given differential equation convert into g of y by x. So then put y by x as b. Then differentiating, we just get this. Substitute the equation number 2 in 1. Put the equation number 2 in 1. Put the equation number 2 in the equation number 1. We have. What we have to substitute? Wherever dy by dx is the replace this one. Because in terms of phi, we are getting. So what is the dy by dx? Dy by dx is equal to p plus x into dv by dx. Dy by dx is over. Is equal to. I just take this one. G of. What is the y by x? Y by x is nothing but what? Y by x is nothing but p. That is g of p. Now, again, after getting substitution, then separate the variable means p. Whatever variable we have, x is a variable, p is the variable. P comes on side, x comes on side. Then p is the right hand side. What happens? X into dv by dx is equal to g of p minus p. G of p minus p. Again, you can do the variable separate the variable. Here, x into the x is the right hand side. G of p minus p taken to left hand side. So that I just have 1 divided by g of p minus p into dv is equal to x is shifted into right hand side 1 by x, dx is shifted into right hand side is equal to 1 by x into dx, which is that. If it is not visible, means I will write here. So I just write on that side. Taken 1 by g of p minus p into dv as it is equal to 1 by x into dx. All the variables are separated. Are you got my point? Next, integrating, just integrating. Already with respect to which variable is mentioned is that, because element of integration here dv is that, here dx is that, no problem. So integration of 1 divided by g of p minus p into dv is equal to integration of 1 by x into dx. If you integrate this one, we will get the required answer. Whatever the answer we are going to get, that is our required solution of the given differential equation dy by dx is equal. After integration, whatever the solution we are getting, that is our required solution of the given differential equation by the method of homogeneous. Are you clear? So here mention this standard stuff. in each and every problem we have to face the same things, we have to do the same thing. So here there is one of the solution. Complete the equation, we will get the solution. Another one is that, what is the another one? That is nothing but dy by dx is equal to f of x comma y. That f of x comma y can be expressed as h of x by y, h of x by y. In this case, how will you do that? Same process we have to do. What is the same process? Substitution. Put x by y is equal to x by y is equal to denominator of second into right hand side v into y. Here, differentiating with respect to what? Observe that y value in terms of x, so that differentiating with respect to x. Here, x value in terms of y, differentiating with respect to what? Now, one more thing. Here it is not a dy by x. Here we get the dx by dy. Dx divided by dy. Dy by dx means y by x will get it. Dx by dy is nothing but x by y will get it. Next problems are there, we'll discuss. Dx by dy is equal to h of x comma y. It is at 0 degree. 0 degree is nothing but here which value are taken common? Y is taken common. So x by y is equal to b. X is equal to in terms of y is that. So differentiating dx by dy is equal to differentiating with respect to y. Differentiating with respect to y. In this case, x is a dependent variable, y is an independent variable at this moment. Okay, differentiating, what we get with respect to y is that dx by dy is equal to, so differentiation of y with respect to y is 1, second function, first function answer is plus y answer is dv by dy. Now this is equation number 2, this is equation number 1. Put the equation number 2 into 1, what happens? Dx by dy is nothing but p plus y into dv by dy is equal to h of x by y is what? It is a p is that separating the variable, integrating, we get the required solution. Are you clear? I think. Now you got the point. Y is written now. Two pumps taking once x is common, taking once y is common, two functions are just written. G of y by x, h of x by y, two pumps are just written. Why I just written those two formulas? Because of these two different conditions are there. First time they might have given that dy by dx, or second time they might have given the dx by dy. So either any of the method if they given, either if they given, we have to proceed in this manner. If they given dx by dy, we have to proceed in this manner. Okay, just mention this one. Here as usual, the standard method. Then I just directly go to the example. Now go to the one particular example. Let us come to know that how to solve the given differential equation in the homogeneous method. Solve the differential equation x minus y into dy by x is equal to x plus 2y is homogeneous. We need to show that this differential equation is homogeneous and solve it. We have to solve it. Okay. So given differential equation is given x minus y into dy by dx is equal to x plus 2y. We need to show this is the homogeneous. Homogeneous is nothing but what? Suppose that dy by dx is equal to the differential equation dy by dx is equal to f of x comma y is that. Then we need to replace x as the lambda x, y as the lambda y, after simplification lambda power n into f of x comma y, then nth degree homogeneous function. But we are solving only the 0th degree homogeneous function, that is lambda power 0 into f of x comma y. This is one method. Another method is taking the variable is common. Here it is dy by dx is that. So we have to take the x is common. X into g of y by x, x power 0 or x power 1, whatever. X power 0 into g of y by x, then it is 0th degree homogeneous function. Either first method or second method. First method is very easy, so that I just not suggesting this one. Okay, you can try it. First method as well as the second method. Which one is convenient to you, that method you can apply. So I am just proceed by the first method. First method is nothing but first of all express the dy by dx is equal to. What is the dy by dx? Dy by dx is equal to x plus 2 into y divided by x minus 1. Okay. It is a 0 degree homogeneous function or first degree homogeneous function, second and third, fourth, like what is the degree of the homogeneous function? We have to check it. Differential equation, first degree is the first degree differential is that, but homogeneous function f of x and y we have to check it. So for that, what we have to do? Replace x as a lambda x and y as a lambda y, where lambda is a non-zero real number. So I just consider first of all, in the before we do this one, let's consider that let f of x comma y is equal to, that I just write f of x comma y is equal to, let f of x comma y, what is f of x comma y, x plus 2y, x minus 1 is just right below. Then wherever x is the, replace the lambda x, wherever y is the, replace the lambda y. Some people used to write that x is equal to lambda x naught, y is equal to lambda y to make the difference. Here y is that, y naught, different value, nothing to worry, you can write it. X as a lambda x, y as a lambda y, nothing to worry. Replacing wherever x is the lambda x, that means lambda x plus 2 into lambda y divided by lambda x minus lambda y. Here numerator, I just take the lambda x common, then what is left? X plus 2y is left divided by lambda is common, x minus y is left. Here lambda get cancelled, remaining term what is that? X plus 2y divided by x minus y, that is nothing but, can I write that f of x comma y, lambda is cancelled, can I write the lambda power 0? So what this is called, f of lambda x comma lambda y is equal to lambda power 0 times of f of x comma y. Therefore what we can say that f of x comma y is the 0th degree homogeneous function. 0th degree homogeneous function. 0th degree homogeneous function. Very clear? RS probably I just do that. Here you take an x is common. Because dy by dx means you have to take the x is common. X is common. What is that? Numerator 1 plus 2 into y by x. Here also x is common. 1 minus y by x, x is the answer. This is of the form x power 0 into g of y by x. What is it? g of y by x is nothing but 1 plus 2 into y by x divided by 1 minus y by x. This is also okay. Which one is convenient? That method is just applied. Now we have shown the given differential equation, that function is a homogeneous function. The homogeneous function is over. Next thing is, homogeneous is over. Next, proceed. And solve it. They are asking to solve the equation. How to solve this one? Means, again I just write that dy by dx is equal to here, x plus 2y divided by x minus y. Very carefully observe it. X plus 2y divided by x minus y. I need to solve this differential equation. To solve this one, we have to make the substitution. What is the substitution? Dy by dx means we have to put the y by x is equal to p, and we need to proceed. So that I just rewrite. How I just rewrite? X is common. If we take an x is common, 1 plus 2 into y by x divided by, again x is common in the denominator, 1 minus y by x. Here x get the answer. Are you clear? So again I just write 1 plus 2 into y by x divided by 1 minus y by x. Here dy by dx is equal to 1 plus 2 into y by x minus divided by 1 minus y by x. Here I am just going to do the substitution. What is the substitution? Put y by x is equal to p. Put to y by x is equal to p, because we need to replace the dy by dx. We need to specify that dy by dx is equal to 1 plus 2 into y by x divided by 1 minus y by x. Okay, so put, and I just write this is the y is equal to px. Or instead of writing y by x is equal to p, you can write it y is equal to px. And here differentiating with respect to what? X. So dy by dx is equal to p plus x into dv by dx. You can remember this, no problem. Product rule of the differentiation, very simple differentiation. Now this is the equation number 1. This is the equation number. Put the equation number 2 in 1. Or using the equation number 2, using the equation number 2, equation number 1 implies. What is equation number 1 implies? Dy by dx can be replaced as p plus x into dv by dx is equal to dy by dx, what is replaced? Is equal to 1 plus 2 into y by x. What is y by x? It is a p divided by 1 minus y by x, 1 minus y by x is p. Okay, now separate the variable. Always separate the variable. First of all, shift the p into right hand side. X into dv by dx is equal to 1 plus 2p divided by 1 minus p minus p. Taking LCM. Now simplify. Just simplification is that dv by dx into x is equal to simplification. LCM term is 1 minus p. Minus so x into dv by dx is equal to 1 plus 2 into p. 1 minus p is LCM, minus p minus minus plus p square divided by 1 minus p. Pi is written, LCM is 1 minus p, p into 1 minus p, minus p into 1 minus minus plus p square. Okay, now check it. What happens? 1 as it is plus 2p minus p is plus p and plus p square divided by 1 minus p. Left hand side x into dv by dx. X into dv by dx. Okay. Next thing. What is the next thing? After this, getting this one, separate the variable. Okay. I just wrote this. Yes. Here, separate the variable. P comes on side. X comes on side. Here dx is a shift the x into right hand side, taking all these terms into left hand side. This is 1 minus p divided by 1 plus p square into dv is equal to x is shifted into right hand side, 1 by x into dx. Okay, now we have separated the variable. So in the homogeneous function, first we have to write the y by x form, then put the y by x is equal to b, differentiate dy by dx value, will get it, replace the dy by dx into the original differential equation, then again do the simplification. After simplification, again we need to apply the first method, that is variable separable method. If you thorough with the variable separable method, then you can easily proceed. Apart from that, you should very clear about the integration part. That is first chapter in the part 2 integration. Each and every method of the integration you should know. Each and every formula you should know. Unless the formula and the method, you can't do the integration yet. So basically, we should have the integration. Integration is nothing but now onwards. In this chapter, it is nothing but the numbers in the mathematics. If you know the numbers, then only you can calculate the multiplication, subtraction, division, like that, or tables you can remember. Unless knowing the numbers, we can't study. That is the way. So if you know the formula and the methods of integration, then we can easily analyze or easily solve the differential equation problems, homogeneous method or variable separable method, whatever. Okay. Now integrating on both sides. If you integrate, what will get? Integration of, so 1 minus p divided by, I just take that 1 minus p divided by p square plus p plus 1 into dv is equal to integration of 1 by x into dx. Integration of 1 by x into dx. Next thing. So integrate that given function. How do you integrate the given function? Let's check it. To integrate this one, how can we integrate? To integrate this one, I just rewrite this one. Here 1 minus b is there, b square. I just take the minus is common. You could take the minus is common, b minus 1. Here minus is there, I just take the minus into right hand side, b square plus 1 into dv. Here minus is outside 1 by x into dx. Or multiplying both by minus sign. Now, integrate this one. How to integrate? So, numerator linear function, denominator quadratic equation. Okay. Whether it is of form px plus q divided by ax square plus bx plus c, whether the given integral is of the form px plus q divided by x square plus bx plus c, yes or no? How do we solve this one? Integration of a into b by dx of ax square plus bx plus c plus b. Do you know this method? Yes or no? So, in this method, it is better to solve it. So instead of doing this all the stuff, I just directly need to convert. How I just convert? Here you used to convert that a into f dash of x divided by f of x formula you used to get it. In the same manner, I'm just trying to get directly. How to get directly means if you differentiate the denominator term, what happens? Assume that p is nothing but x. So if you differentiate x square plus x plus p divided by x minus 1 is there. If you differentiate, what we get? 2x plus 1. Try to write the numerator 2x plus 1 or 2b plus 1. How do we get? So multiply and divide by 2. Multiply by 2 to the numerator 2b minus 2 divided by p square plus p plus 1. Actually, we need the 2b plus 1. Actually, I just need the 2b plus 1. This minus plus 1 minus 1. Add and subtract the plus 1 minus 1. Add and subtract the 1. So 2b plus 1. I just write directly. So 2b plus 1 minus 3. Check it. After simplification, will you get the 2b minus 2? Then 2 is common, b minus 1, will you get it? Yes or no? So this is the b square plus b plus 1 into dv is equal to minus 1 by x into dx. Next, 1 by 2 also separate the integral. 1 by 2 into 2b plus 1 divided by b square plus b plus 1 into dv minus 3. 1 by 2 is common, product 3 by 2 into 1 divided by b square plus b plus 1 into dv minus integration of 1 by x into dx. The first term integration is over because f dash of x divided by f of x. How will you do the second term integration? Second term integration means 1 divided by p square plus p plus 1 is that. That is nothing but 1 divided by ax square plus bx plus c. How will you do this? For doing this one, making perfect square, some value a plus some value whole square plus c square. In that manner, you have to do that. So, yes, proceed. What will you get? Second. So, this is the directly integration you can do it. Now, making perfect square. How will you do the making perfect square? In perfect square, ax square plus bx plus c is equal. There is a particular formula as that a into x plus 2b by a whole square plus like that. A particular formula as that. Unless that. Instead of that one, I just do directly. How I just do directly means p square plus p plus 1 is that. Try to get the either a plus b whole square or a minus b whole square. A plus b whole square means a square plus 2ab plus b square. Or else a square minus 2ab plus b square in this manner. Okay. So here I just write p square as p square. Here plus is the plus. For the p, multiply by 2 and divide by 2. Multiply by 2 and divide by 2. A square is the plus. A value is b. B value. It is 2 as it is 2. B value. What is this value? B 1 by 2. So plus b square is equal. 1 by 2 whole square minus 1 by 2 whole square. I replace and plus 1 as it is plus 1. Now first the three terms. What we can write? I got my point. I think in the first position level also, which is in this manner, or is directly formula is that you can apply that formula. Okay, instead of remembering the formula, better do the manually. P square plus 2 into B, 2 in A, A will be already P square. In place of B, 1 by 2 is there. We need the P square. Add by P square, subtract by P square. Then plus 1 as P square. What we can write the first 3 terms? P plus 1 by 2 whole square. A plus 2 whole square. Exponent is filled. Minus as it is minus. Minus. 1 by 2 whole square is 1 by 2 plus 1. Are you clear? Minus is outside the square. Simplify. Minus 1 by 4 plus 1. What happens? Minus 1 plus 4 divided by 4. 3 by 4 plus 3 by 4. So I just write directly 3 by 4. What will you get? 3 by 4. But to write one step. P plus 1 by 2 whole square plus 3 divided by 4. Now it is in the standard form. 3 by 4 can be written as root 3 divided by 2. Root 3 divided by 2 whole square. A square plus B square or X square plus A square form is stated. Now I just write 1 by 2 into integration of 2B plus 1 divided by B square plus B plus 1 into DB. Minus 3 by 2 as it is integration of 1 by b square plus p can be written as b square plus p plus 1 can be written as this much 1 divided by p plus 1 by 2 whole square plus root 3 by 2 whole square into dv is equal to minus 1 divided by x into dx integration. Okay, now it is the standard form. Integration of f dash of x divided by f of x. Now it is in the standard form. 1 integration of 1 divided by x square plus a square. Now what is the integration of f dash of x divided by f of x? This is the log of f of x. And this is 1 by a into tan inverse of x by a plus a. Are you sure? Have you remember this formulas? Okay, I just directly apply the formulas here. What we get. So here I am just going to write left hand side. What is the left hand side? Both the values are there. Here is equal is there. So left hand side. What is the left hand side value? 1 by 2 as it is 1 by 2. Integration of 2b plus. Here it is not covered, I just write here. One by two times of this 1/2 as it is integration of f dash of x divided by f of x. That we can write as a log of f of x, log of p square plus p plus 1. This term integration is over, minus 3 by 2 into integration of 1 divided by 3 plus 1 by 2 whole square plus 4 divided by 2, which is of the form 1 by x square plus a square, 1 by a into 1 by a, what is the a value? A value is root 3 by 2, 1 divided by root 3 by 2 divided by 2 taken to the numerator, root 3 by 2 into tan inverse of x by a, what is that x? This is the x, p plus 1 by 2. Divided by a, root 3 divided by 2. Okay, tan inverse of x by a is equal to minus as is minus integration of 1 by x is log of mod x plus c. Instead of writing the plus c, plus c, plus c, write better write only once because c1, c2, c3. Combinedly, you can write the c3, c. Okay, now simplify. How to simplify? Here, will you get the answer? 1 by 2 into log of p square plus p plus 1 minus 3 divided by root 3 can be written as root 3 into tan inverse of here divided by 2 get cancelled. 2d plus 1 divided by root 3 denominator LCM term 2 get cancelled is equal to minus log of mod x plus c. c. Okay, now actually the given differential equation dy by dx is there, so it is not in the dy by dx form. So replace the p value. What is the p value? We have taken p is y by x. Put y by x is equal to p. Wherever p is there, replace the y by x. Log of y square by x square plus y by x plus 1 minus root 3 tan inverse of 2 into y by x plus 1 divided by root 3 minus log of mod of x plus c. Simplify 1 by doing log of x square is LCM, y square plus x into y plus x square divided by x star minus root 3 into tan inverse of 2y plus x divided by root 3 into x is equal to minus log of x plus c. Minus log of x plus c. Okay. Later words. A little simplify. Again you can simplify this one. Log of x square is there. Okay. Here. 1 by 2 is that log of. This we can write x square or y square now. Y square plus x into y plus x square. Log of m by n. What is the log of m by n? Log of m by n is log m minus log m. Log of m minus log m. 1 by 2 is that. So log of x square. 4 over 1 by 2. It is log of x. I got this point. How this log x comes? Log of m by n. Log m is over minus log m. But product is 1 by 2 is that. 1 by 2 into log of x square. 1 by 2 taken here. X square power 1 by 2. 2 to get the answer. Log x is 11. Minus root 3 into tan inverse of 2y plus x divided by root 3 into x is equal to minus log of mod x plus c. Here minus log x, here minus log x, get cancelled. What is the remaining term? So here 1 by 2 or log of 1 by 2 theta is 1 by 2 into log of y square plus x into y plus x square minus root 3 into tan inverse of 2y plus x divided by root 3x is equal to c. This is the required solution of the given differential equation. This is the required solution of the given differential equation. What is that differential equation? Dy by dx is equal to the argument x plus 2y. What is that? Dy by dx is equal to x plus 2y divided by x minus 1. X plus 2y divided by x minus 1. This differential equation solution is this one. Is that clear? Directly which is not possible to apply the variable separable method here. Observe. Is it possible to apply the directly the variable separable method? The variables will not separate because sum and difference Rashmi function is there. So that reason we have to apply the homogeneous method. So make the difference. For which problem we have to apply the variable separable method or homogeneous method? Just clarify. If it is possible to apply the, check it. Whether it is possible to apply the variable separable method directly. Directly it is not possible. First we have to do the homogeneous, then substitution y by x is equal to b. Simplifying integration part is the this type of integration. People already did in the chapter integration. No matter at all. So practice, practice, practice. In the calculus part, practice is very important. Repeatedly I am just telling that formula and daily we have to practice. Unless it is not possible to, nothing is more than that. Only very simple thing is that just practice. Due to practice only you can get it. Is that clear? Okay. I just stop here. We will continue in the next video. Okay. Thank you.